All right, Kate, let's send it back over to you.
Yeah. Now, Reynolds, imagine that you own a beautiful lakefront home, right? You buy this, you want to get up in the morning, stretch, have your cup of coffee, have it, look at the lake. The lake is gone, though. It's completely out of there. That is exactly what happened in one Georgia community. So where did the lake go? Our Dave Malkoff investigates.
Those geese are angry. You would be, too. Their beautiful Georgia lake, where they just had their babies this past Mother's Day, is gone. Dried up, ironically, by a powerful, rainy thunderstorm.
We had never seen the lake level get this high, and it was rising and rising. And the next morning, it was gone. This lake was completely gone. I'm Joey Hack.
And he's never seen anything like it in nearly a decade of living on this lake. You see, it's kept full until that storm, at least, by a big earthen dam.
Well, right over there is 30-foot breach.
The neighborhood theory is the rain sliced the dam apart, letting all the water drain out. Now, back in 2007, we've confirmed a strong tornado roared through this area near Noonan, Georgia, and it passed right over the lake. Now, that was some 8 years ago, but neighbors think that tornado set the dam up for failure.
Out of this entire lake, the only place where there's water is this little puddle back here. Apparently, there's still fish in there. And there's a guy who came over to rescue them.
Yeah, we call him the Turtle Man. Got on his stomach and was catching these fish and putting them in coolers, taking them to the other lake.
Just like the 10 families in this neighborhood, this little turtle has a long journey back to a normal life. Joey says he can't come up with the money or the permits to fix what nature took away. The family of geese can't move either. Their goslings can't fly yet.
They were like, what happened to the lake? And they were bewildered. And so we got a little pool for them to get in there, trying to watch them.
Somehow a kiddie pool is just no replacement for anybody here on Georgia's disappearing lake.
We're going to miss it. I just hate it.
Dave Malkoff, The Weather Channel.
Wow. Remarkable.
Yeah, it really is. I mean, just what a turn of events it is for them. And certainly a turn of events for people who are now in, say, down in parts of the coast of Mexico, where some people are planning vacations. Now they've got Hurricane Blanca that's turning off the coast, possibly headed to the Baja.
This is going to have impacts on Mexico. It already is in the form of waves, some rain. But what about the Baja? Are we going to see some big issues there? What if you could safely simulate Category 5 conditions? Well, you can, actually. It's a test tank. We're going to show you how that works.
Absolutely. Coming up, the hurricane machine will help communities prepare for the worst. And right now in New York City, you're preparing for a few scattered showers out there. We've had some come through. And there you go, Gotham City. Rain's coming down. Decent
wet
day, though.
Morning.
I know.
What's with the sash?
Oh, I'm a blast scout.
What are all these for?
Yeah, they're all for different things. This one's for eating a blast.
Oh, cool.
This one's for getting someone to buy me a blast.
What's that one for?
That one's covering up a hole.
Tons of surprising Master Blast flavor combos you're sure to love. This is how you Sonic.
Okay, guys, we've got two cars here, and we're going to start watching a movie in the Chevy Malibu.
He's flying.
Okay, guys, pause the movie. We're going to watch the rest of it in the Toyota Camry. Hit play again.
You can't watch the movie. No network connection.
Who wants to go back in the Chevy Malibu?
Me.
Let's go.
He's out.
Chevrolet, the first and only car company to bring built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi to cars, trucks, and crossovers.
This is cool.
Yeah.
Remember when you said men are superior drivers?
Yeah.
Yeah. Then how'd I get this?
Allstate Safe Driving Bonus Check.
What is that?
So weird, right? My agent Tom said
only Allstate sends you a bonus check for every 6 months you're accident-free.
But I'm a woman. Maybe it's a misprint. Does it look like a misprint?
Okay, let's try.
Silence. Ask an Allstate agent about the safe driving bonus check. Are you in good hands?
Time to sweat, boys. Big time.
Let's get this thing right.
I have made fire!
Fat Guys in the Woods. New season starts tomorrow, only on the Weather Channel.
Things move fast around here. Who's got time to look at the fine print? So you see DirecTV's new offer. $19, you think. But after just 3 months, you're paying over $100 a month, and it keeps going up. Turns out you're locked into a 2-year contract that could cost you nearly $3,000. Thinking about DirecTV? Think again.
Don't fall for DirecTV's latest offer. There's nothing direct about DirecTV.
If you're not happy with how your allergy medicine treats your congestion, rethink relief with Nasacort Allergy 24-Hour. Unlike antihistamines that target only one cause of your symptoms, Nasacort stops more, relieving the worst nasal allergy symptoms, even congestion, for 24 hours. It's non-addictive and has no harsh taste, and unlike Flonase, it's scent and alcohol-free. And it's available over-the-counter at full prescription strength. Rethink your relief with Nasacort. It stops more of what makes you miserable.
Monday morning, storm stretching from the Ohio Valley to the Northeast. We've got the timing for the danger. Wake up with Al, AMHQ, Monday morning at 5, only on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 74 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. High 86. Chance of rain 60%. Tonight, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Mostly cloudy. Low 74. Sunday, partly cloudy. High 85. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
All right, welcome back to Weather Center. We're on AMHQ weekend, aren't we?
Yes, we are.
Is it Saturday already?
Yes, it is.
Okay, so breaking this morning, this was new news to us. Hurricane Blanca in the eastern Pacific, it strengthened overnight.
Yeah, a lot. And you know, somewhat surprisingly, maybe some of us thought that it would weaken like continually, but it got a rebound last night, picked up some strength, now 120 miles per hour on the wind speed. The hurricane hunters will be out there again today to reassess that. And there's some satellite-derived estimates on its strength that are a lot higher than 120 miles per hour, just letting you know. But this is what we're going with. This is the official number from the Hurricane Center. Northwest at 12, Kate, that's on a motion about like that. So southern parts of Baja, probably going to miss the core of this thing, but we'll get glanced by at least tropical storm force winds, I think, tomorrow.
Looks like when the sun comes up there this morning, you're actually already going to see some clouds this, and you're already seeing the waves all up and down the west coast of Mexico.
Yeah, real good point. You know, there are going to be some really pretty pictures, I think, coming out of that part of the world with the, you know, when the hurricane's on the horizon, I've seen this many times, you have too, that the cloud canopy is beautiful to see.
It's gorgeous.
And I think we'll see some of that and also some very big waves there. So keep an eye for that.
But how about safety?
Oh, yes. Don't get in the water. Those rough waters are very dangerous, especially with the high wave heights we expect with this thing. This is a beast, really. I mean, it's a lot stronger than it was yesterday. Those purples and reds, those are the very tall, cold cloud tops, the tall thunderstorms that have helped spin it up overnight. And with all that in play, the National Hurricane Center has gone ahead and put out the tropical storm warnings and the hurricane watches for that part of the world.
So even though you're kind of anticipating that this is going to weaken, it's still going to be a moisture issue. You're still going to see a lot of rain. We could see some flash flooding. You could see some winds from this.
Yes, we think tropical storm force winds are possible, if not probable, for Cabo San Lucas with heavy rain at times, kind of a showery, squally type thing. But again, the core of it remaining offshore, that certainly appears to be the case.
Even though the winds weaken, the moisture has to go somewhere.
It does. Good point. And you know what? That's a great segue, Kate, because this thing continues on past Cabo, and the moisture, not the wind, but the moisture and maybe some of the dynamics with sort of getting squeezed out in parts of the southwest U.S. by about Tuesday or Wednesday with some enhanced rainfall, we think, of a couple of inches possible in the southwest. That's a lot for them.
You know, my uncle is just saying in Phoenix that it's great news they've got. They want this rain because a lot of their lakes are really low.
Yes, and I think they're going to see it midweek.
That's good news. Okay, back to you, Reynolds.
All right, guys, thanks so much. Switching gears a bit, as Mexico braces for Hurricane Blanca this morning, we want to take a look at what really happens inside the structure of a hurricane. Well, researchers in Southwest Florida are doing just that with a one-of-a-kind simulator. David Hodges has the story.
It's a fitting name for the ultimate goal. Use this hurricane simulator and learn how to withstand a Category 5 hurricane.
So we can have more resilient communities here in South Florida and the rest of the world's coastlines.
Dr. Brian House is director of the new tank at the University of Miami. He says Sustain is the first tank that can simulate a Cat 5 hurricane. With 1,400 horsepower fans, it generates winds more than 150 miles per hour. House says don't even think about stepping inside then.
No. No, there's no way you could be able, you would be blown, certainly blown through the back of the system.
And that makes it just like a real hurricane. He says it will give them better data about what type of structures stand up to these high winds and how pollutants like oil spread across the ocean during a storm.
So that if there's another spill event, the resources can be targeted in the best way to handle them.
The tank is made of acrylic. It's completely see-through from all sides. House is hoping it will also give his team a glimpse of how to handle future storms.
We need to learn how to build better or else we're not going to be able to continue to thrive here in South Florida.
My goodness, what a story. We'll still head on AMHQ Weekend, a look at the places in the crosshairs for severe weather this weekend and when the weather may turn nasty right on your doorstep. Plus, American Pharoah could make history at the Belmont Stakes in just a few hours. A look at the weather the horses will be dealing with later. And if you're not headed to the Belmont Stakes, why not check this out? Duluth, Minnesota. A little foggy this morning, but still going to be a great day. And here's a fun fact. Back in the late 1800s, Duluth was home to more millionaires per capita than any other place in the world. And you know what else is cool in Duluth? North Shore Scenic Drive from Duluth to Grand Portage National Park. If you're taking a drive today, there's your forecast. Looks like a mix of sun and clouds. Temperatures mainly in the 60s. Keep the windows down. It's going to be spectacular for you. This is a beautiful drive. In fact, one may argue, it is a prettier drive than going from Toledo to Cincinnati. I know, shocking, hard to believe. Folks, enjoy yourself. We've got more coming up. You're watching AMHQ Weekend. Sit tight.
Best Scenic Drives, brought to you by Volvo.
Leave early. Go roam. Sleep in. Sleep out. Stargaze. Dream big. Wander more. Care less. Beat sunrise. Chase sunset. Do it all on us. Get your first month's payment plus 5 years wear and tear coverage. Make the most of summer with Volvo.
In a world of fake, fried, and frozen, Boston Market promises to make food good. Like our all-natural rotisserie chicken. Now meals start at just $6.99. Boston Market, all good.
Six smoky hours, one tasty dish, slow-braised pulled pork, now at Boston Market.
One of the fort's favorite rituals happens at the water's edge. Here they must look their best. Smooth, beautiful skin is an advantage. The others can only hide in shame. Introducing the new Dr. Scholl's Dreamwalk Express Petty.
The Honda ATV clearance event is going on now, which means it's your time to ride red and save green. Your Honda dealer is offering incredible deals on America's best-selling ATV lineup, the Rugged Rancher, Dependable Foreman, and Trail Hungry Rubicon. Right now, get up to $500 in bonus bucks on select models and fixed financing rates as low as 2.99%. So if you're ready to ride red and save serious green, then head to the Honda ATV clearance event today.
At the Barrett Jackson Auto Auction, cars like these can go for a cool million easy. How? It starts with the details, and nobody does details like new Barrett Jackson Premium Auto Care. Liquid wax, formulated for a Barrett Jackson quality finish with advanced polymer technology for unbeatable protection and a residue-free shine, making your car look like a cool million by the people who know cars that look like a cool million. Oh. Try new Barrett Jackson Liquid Car Wax and Barrett Jackson Premium Auto Care products, available at these fine retailers.
Dads who would do anything for golf deserve a store that would do anything for dads. Visit Golfsmith for the best Father's Day gifts at the guaranteed lowest prices. Golfsmith, anything for golf.
Everyone, remain calm.
2019.
Currently in our area, 74 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. High 86. Chance of rain 60%. Tonight, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Mostly cloudy. Low 74. Sunday, partly cloudy. High 85. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Fat Guys in the Woods. New season starts tomorrow on the Weather Channel.
We actually saw the tornado from our front porch.
This thing has gotten much bigger. This is a large tornado now.
There it is! We have touchdown, people!
Complete shock, because we've never seen anything like that here before.
Hey, did you guys notice the first bit of video that we had there? It was like a small pond, like a farm pond, mm-hmm. and you saw the splashes coming up from the hail, which is compelling enough.
Yeah.
But then in the background, you had the big tornado.
Yeah, yeah.
So, my gosh, yeah. Take your pick. Folks, it has been that kind of morning. There it is. Thanks so much.
That's a phenomenal hail. Video,
Isn't
too.
Isn't that crazy?
Yeah.
My gosh, folks, welcome to a crazy morning. I'm meteorologist Reynolds Wolf. Your buddy and mine, Kate Parker's here, as well as our good friend, Dr. Greg Postel. More severe weather looks like it may be on tap today.
Yeah, it looks like more in the forecast, and we don't need any more of it, especially on the weekend, but it's just this time of year. But, you know, it's kind of focused more in the northern plains, right? Mm-hmm. With the lifting of the jet this time of year.
Yep, it looks like it's shifting northward, but you know what? There are other places in the country that are going to have some fantastic weather today, in particular, the Great Lakes, Chicago. This is unbelievable. Yeah. How about this for early June? Highs in the 70s up there. That's great. It's typically warm in the south. Dallas, 92 degrees today. So really, overall, we're not looking at any big heat right now across the country. I kind of like that.
Chicago's looking like a beach day.
Yeah.
Good thinking there.
To the beach.
Nice idea.
It's going to be pretty busy. Okay. But, you know, some people are working on cleanup today,
That's
actually.
True.
And we want some nice weather for them. It's not necessarily in the forecast, though. Look at this from 2 days ago. This is a storm swept through northern Colorado. This is video out of Larimer County. 25 homes damaged. This one, obviously, completely destroyed. Both Larimer and Boulder counties were hit here. Okay, so obviously, this was a home. There's nothing left in that. That's why tornado warnings are issued. This is why we tell you to get in a safe spot. Although, you guys, Dr. Postel, Reynolds, I don't see a safe spot in that home. I mean, it's splintered. There's nothing left.
You're right. I mean, it's like a giant weed eater came through and, I mean, just scrubbed everything clean. The foundation, really the only thing that's contained. But look, Dr. Greg, look how random that is. You see, that place obliterated, but looks like a few hundred yards away. It looks like there are buildings, outbuildings, that are unscathed.
That's the hallmark of tornado damage. I mean, it's very house by house, block by block. You know, you get the crazy wind speeds 10 meters away from you. There are almost no wind speeds. So it's that kind of variability that you see in those damage patterns. Very, very unfortunate, but commonly seen with that kind of severe weather moving through.
Well, the atmospheric setup that we had then, when that took place, any similarities to what we might be dealing with today?
Yes. I think quite similar. Across parts of the northern plains, we have the Dakotas, parts of southwestern Minnesota, even northwest Iowa. Watch out for the chance of severe thunderstorms, the likelihood of severe thunderstorms, with the possibility of a tornado or two. The primary risk is high wind and hail, but the tornado threat does exist today. Right now, we don't have any severe thunderstorm warnings, but Look at what we've got here.
Oh, yeah.
A cluster of heavy rainers moving through parts of northern Kansas. They're going to get into Kansas City, I think, in the next hour or two. So watch out for some lightning and thunder and heavy rain. We've got a flash flood warning out for the area just to the northwest in Republican Washington counties in Kansas. That's out over here, just south of Beatrice, Nebraska. But here's some storms coming in through St. Joe.
Get ready.
Get ready, Kansas City. Watch out, Topeka, Lawrence, every lovely little town in between Leavenworth, Kansas. You are going to get some thunderstorms this morning rolling right along these tracks, Reynolds. This is a stationary boundary, right? Mm-hmm. And that is serving as the sort of, I guess, conduit through which these things are propagating. So watch out along the front here. That's where those storms are going.
Quick
but later
movers,
on today.
Fast-moving storms, you think?
Yeah, pretty fast.
Okay.
And so there'll be a lot of heavy rain with possible some flash flooding threat, but they'll be moving along pretty quickly and get out of your hair just in time for the new round coming later on this afternoon, right?
Goodness.
But that's going to be farther to the north because this boundary today is going to be turning into a warm front lifting northward, and we'll see some strong winds rolling around up here, and that is going to set us up for seen, I think, this year for the most part. Look way up there in North Dakota, Minnesota, even parts of Nebraska. Big storms possible, a tornado or two.
Loud times, all but a certainty. All right,
yes.
Let's send it back over to Kate. She's got more on the severe weather threat.
Yeah, so with that, we see the overnight hours a threat for some of those spots. But hold tight, because Wichita, Kansas, Chicago, Illinois, New York City, your forecast is shifting. And we want to get you ready for Sunday and Monday because you have the threat of large hail and damaging winds. Let's take a look at that. Some spots even have the threat of an isolated tornado. Can't be ruled out. Here's where that front will develop. You know, Dr. Postel was talking about the warm front. By the time we get to your Sunday, that lifts off to the northeast, and this cold front is left behind. This draped right across I-70, across Kansas, into Missouri, and then stretching on into Illinois, Indiana. That's where you have the risk of severe storms for your Sunday plans. In fact, Torcons already up for Sunday. We've got a Torcon of 3 for Chicago, Madison, and Grand Rapids. This is, again, through the evening and overnight, going Sunday night and into Monday, which means you have to have something to wake you up through the overnight hours because you could see some of those strong storms as you're sleeping. Anytime you have damaging winds or an isolated tornado at night, it becomes exponentially more dangerous because you can't take cover if you're not aware of it. So tomorrow night, we see that move on down to the south. That cold front sweeps through. By the time we get to Monday, it's still lingering because this isn't just a due west to east kind of a sweep. It's kind of just sagging south. And so with that, we see the lingering threat of showers and thunderstorms across southern Missouri, Illinois, and then Kentucky on into West Virginia and the Northeast. By Monday, you have thunderstorms still in the forecast. We could even see a few thunderstorms in Maine, as well as the nation's capital. Going into Monday night, New York City, you have the risk of some thunder and lightning and even possible severe weather in the coming days, Reynolds, something we definitely need to stay on top of.
Always, absolutely. You know, and speaking of severe weather, flooding continues to be a major issue across the southern plains. The Red River already has gone up 5 feet above flood stage and 35 feet in Shreveport, Louisiana. Nearby Bossier City, police have asked residents that are closest to the river to evacuate. And the state's governor, Bobby Jindal, toured a number of already flooded areas on Friday. He also met with emergency officials in the affected areas, and he's pledging to provide state help. All right, folks, there's the gauge for you right now, 34.68. That's the current flow, but up it goes right before Monday, cresting at 36.5 before receding.
Yeah, all that water.
Well, sir, after some serious consideration, I'd like to put in my 15-year notice.
You're quitting?
Technically retiring, sir. With a little help from my State Farm agent, I plan to retire in 15 years.
Wow, you're totally blindsiding me here. Who's going to manage your accounts? This is a devastating blow I was not prepared for.
Well, I'm going to finish packing my things. 15 years will really sneak up on you.
Jennifer will do your exit interview, and Adam made you a cake.
Red velvet.
Oh, thank you.
I made this.
Take charge of your retirement. Talk to a State Farm agent today.
If you've been wishing for something amazing, at Cricket Wireless, we've got it. A special offer on the new Samsung Galaxy S6. Plus, we've got more 4G LTE coverage nationwide than T-Mobile or Sprint. Because a great phone deserves a great network. Cricket Wireless, something to smile about.
Let's do this. Let's move outdoors for the next few months. Let's build a kitchen under the clouds. A dining room with no walls, no ceiling. Let's put it all together, then let's get together, a lot. Let's do this.
Plant Color Everywhere with 12-pack annuals, just $9.98. The Home Depot. More saving. More doing.
I've got plans. And this is my baby right now. So it's just not the right time to get pregnant. That's why I chose Skyla. Skyla is the small, flexible IUD that prevents pregnancy for up to 3 years. So for me, there are no daily pills or monthly refills. I got my Skyla placed in just a few minutes at my OBGYN's office. And if I want to try to get pregnant, I can get it removed whenever I want.
If you have a pelvic infection, get infections easily, or have certain cancers, don't use Skyla. Less than 1% of users get a serious infection called PID. If you have persistent pelvic or stomach pain, or if Skyla comes out, tell your doctor. Skyla may attach or go through the uterus and cause other problems. Pregnancy while using Skyla is uncommon, but can be life-threatening and may result in loss of pregnancy or fertility. Ovarian cysts may occur, but usually disappear. Bleeding and spotting may increase in the first 3 to 6 months and remain irregular. Periods over time usually become shorter, lighter, or may stop. Skyla does not protect against HIV or STDs.
Talk to your OBGYN about making the move to Skyla.
Check with your insurance to find out if you can get Skyla at no cost.
Currently in our area, 74 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. High, 86. Chance of rain, 60%. Tonight, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Mostly cloudy. Low, 74. Sunday, partly cloudy. High, 85. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
My goodness, Colorado really has seen its share of some rough weather this past week. And on Thursday in Elbert County, just south of Denver, they had two tornadoes, two of them. They were spotted within an hour of each other, four homes damaged by the twisters.
Okay, so also on Thursday, about an hour north of Denver, so we went south, now we're going north.
Okay.
We had in Berth Bund, several homes were damaged from strong storms that produced heavy rain, hail in that area. You know, this time of year, we see that threat move a little farther north. It's been the southern plains, and now we're kind of getting up into, you know, the plains of Colorado.
Yeah, and let's take out the bottle and let's take a few more crazy pills because they even had hail, Kate, that piled up. It was like snow. People were actually getting snow shovels and scooping it up. You see more of the damage there, though. That was from some of the strong winds. The state has been just, there it is, there it is. That's the stuff that we were talking about.
That's not snow. It's incredible.
I know.
And incredible.
It is incredible. And what else is really weird about it is the duration. Usually, as you know very well, usually hail does not last long. That took about an hour or so. It just kept moving continuously, and that's what
we
have.
Right over the same area, just that little spot in that neighborhood.
Absolutely.
Okay, check out this not so little spot. This is oh my gosh.
I know.
This poor police supervisor. Okay, a giant sinkhole opened in the town of Sheridan. It swallowed a police supervisor's car early on Friday morning. The officer in the car actually had to crawl out of the car and onto the roof to escape. He was checked out at a hospital, later released there, but man, he is going to have a hard time because the guys at the department are going to be making him buy the donuts and coffee for a long while.
Embarrassment can be a tough thing, you know, and that's going to be kind of rough. But I'll tell you what else may be rough with the severe storms popping up. Kate, they're not out of the woods in Colorado or even in the plains. You see where it's green, it's going to be active there. Where it's red, your best chance of severe storms. And it's going to be a two-act play, Kate. We're going to see it today, but also tomorrow. Look as it drives over into parts of Kansas. Even Monday could be troublesome, Kate.
You know, Denver has the most tornadoes that they see in the month of June. We're into it. Okay, well, kind of changing sides of the country here. Today, the racehorse American Pharoah could make history across the world. Horse racing fans and sports enthusiasts will be closely watching as the Belmont Stakes takes place. Paul Goodloe has a look at how the weather will affect it.
We could be hours away from history with our first Triple Crown winner in about 37 years. The Belmont being run Saturday evening at 6:50 approximate post time. And this is the longest race of the Triple Crown at a mile and a half or 12 furlongs, about a quarter mile longer than they had at the Preakness as well. Let's take a look at the forecast we'll have on Saturday. Maybe a few scattered showers in the morning. Otherwise, we're dry towards the afternoon. Again, post time about 6:50. Temperatures should be in the lower 70s, and it should be dry. The track should be relatively dry as well. Let's take a look at our contender, our three top horses here. We got American Pharoah, yeah, the Derby and the Preakness winner, Frosted and Materiality. Let's first start looking at Materiality in terms of how this horse has performed in past weather conditions and past races. Well, on average, temperatures that this horse runs in is the mid to upper 70s because these three races were in Florida where Materiality won, although it did place sixth in the Kentucky Derby. So this horse does run better in warmer weather. Now let's take a look at Frosted right now. And this horse has only run in the last four races in dry track conditions and temperatures in the upper 60s, the mid 60s here. But again, the only win was this race, and that race was actually in the cooler weather, in the 50s in Queens at Aqueduct. But again, only placed fourth, though, in the Derby, although both these horses did not run in the Preakness, so you would say perhaps they are well-rested. Now, let's go on to our favorite American Pharoah. This horse does it all. It has won all four of its last four races, sometimes in the rain, sometimes in dry track conditions. It doesn't matter, but the average temperature this horse wins in is 69 degrees. So that's pretty close to what our forecast will be for Saturday at 6:50 in the evening. So again, we take a look at our odds here because of the forecasted weather for the Belmont Stakes and performance in past weather. It is so hard based on the weather to pick against American Pharoah. If some horse would come close, I'd actually have to say because of its cool weather condition and the running, I'd say Frosted, but definitely my pick continues to be for our first Triple Crown winner in 37 years based on the weather.
Wow, Paul, thanks so much. Well, and speaking of increasing horsepower, we've got Blanca that went from a Cat 2 to Cat 3.
This morning. Yep. And we have the very latest on what this can mean for Baja California and the Southwest U.S. when we come back.
It's easy to buy insurance and forget about it. But the more you learn about your coverage, the more gaps you may find.
Like how you thought you were covered for this.
It's a profound statement.
But you're not even covered for this.
It's a profound statement.
Or how you may be covered for this, but not for something like this. Talk to farmers and see what gaps could be hiding in your coverage.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Clubs. That's what they tell us a legal golf bag can hold. And while that leaves a little room for balls and tees, it doesn't leave room for much else. There's no room left for deadlines or conference calls. Not a single pocket to hold the stress of the day or the to-do list of tomorrow. Only 14 clubs. Pick out the right one and drive it right down the middle. A pure Michigan. Your trip begins at Michigan.org.
Head and Shoulders with Old Spice, America's number one male dandruff brand. Keeping you 100% flake-free, guaranteed, while smelling 100% handsome. Take a whiff. Head and Shoulders with Old Spice.
Still paying too much for home phone service? Do the math. Magic Jack costs only $35 a year for unlimited local and long-distance calling to the U.S. and Canada. And with the mobile app, get unlimited text messaging.
Unlimited texting for iOS only.
Fat Guys in the Woods. New season starts tomorrow on the Weather Channel.
Things move fast around here. Who's got time to look at the fine print? So you see DirecTV's new offer. $19, you think. But after just 3 months, you're paying over $100 a month, and it keeps going up. Turns out you're locked into a two-year contract that could cost you nearly $3,000. Thinking about DirecTV? Think again.
Don't fall for DirecTV's latest offer. There's nothing direct about DirecTV.
When irritated, itchy summer skin holds me back, I count on Cortisone 10 Intensive Healing. With the strongest non-prescription itch medicine available for fast, long-lasting relief. and 7 moisturizers to help heal skin. Cortisone 10. Feel the heal.
My rough and bumpy skin makes me feel really self-conscious.
Gold Bond Rough and Bumpy Skin Therapy. Used daily, it exfoliates, smooths, softens rough skin, reduces bumps 72%.
I can wear whatever I want. It's liberating.
Gold Bond Ultimate Lotion, Ultimate Skin.
Currently in our area, 74 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. High 86. Chance of rain 60%. Tonight, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Mostly cloudy. Low 74. Sunday, partly cloudy. High 85. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Hurricane Blanca, a major hurricane, winds, you know, fierce in this thing, strengthened overnight. We're in the lab with Dr. Postel. You know, it was kind of a surprise, I think, to some people that this strengthened through the overnight hours.
Yeah, kudos to the Hurricane Center because they sort of projected that it would do one of those sort of brief upticks in intensity like it did last night. It's 120 miles per hour on their estimate right now, but I've seen some other satellite estimates derived because we don't have any aircraft in there right now to tell us for sure how strong it is. But some of the other guidance suggests it's even stronger than that. This may be conservative. So 120 right now, moving northwest to 12. But that's a good motion, Kate, because that will bring the center, we think, about 150 miles to the west of Cabo San Lucas in 36 hours or so.
So this storm, it underwent some really rapid intensification this week. It's hanging out, hasn't had a lot of forward motion, but it's so close to the coast of both Mexico and the Baja Peninsula there. I mean, is this a concern for land? What are we talking about?
Yeah, I think so. The impact's likely to be heavy rain at times, kind of squally-ish, with perhaps tropical storm force wind gusts later on tomorrow. Until then, just watch the big waves coming in and enjoy the pictures of the clouds because they're going to be pretty exceptional as well. Send those to us if you can. But look at this. Let me just show you the close-up here. This is Chicoro Island right here. They have an observing station. I haven't gotten their latest op, but you know, this thing is going to pass very close to them. They'll be on the weaker left side of the storm, but still, they may get some pretty significant data coming in. That would be interesting to see as Blanca passes by later on today, probably, or tonight.
Okay, so this hurricane watch, this was new this morning. We did have those tropical storm warnings already in place for places like Cabo San Lucas, but now under a hurricane watch, what is the likelihood that we see any of those hurricane-like conditions?
Unlikely. It's possible, but unlikely, because this thing is going to be weakening as it moves northward through those cooler waters. See those shades of blue and yellow and green there? Water temperatures are in the 70s, not really capable of supporting the kind of intensity that we've got now. Plus, it's going to be passing to the west. The consensus is for it to track along about like that, which is, let me get a better color for you, about like that. That would likely be 150 miles or so to the west, the center from Cabo and other locations in the southern Baja. That would keep them out of the core, out of the hurricane force winds.
Okay, but so the winds are subsiding, but all that water, all that moisture, it's got to go somewhere.
Yeah, it does. And you were also talking about some big waves and some moisture moving into parts of Mexico as well. But then thereafter, once it goes through this region tomorrow, in Cabo in particular, we're going to talk about coming up at 20 past the hour. There may be some impacts in the southwest U.S. next week.
Yeah, because like we were talking about, all that moisture's got to go somewhere. Useful stuff there. Okay, coming up on AMHQ Weekend, how about spending the night in the wilderness? How about doing it with Sam and Jim and Creek Stewart? Well, that's coming up next.
Devour food that's good for you. The same way you devour food that's not good for you.
What's this?
A box. It takes worn out things and makes them better.
It's our biggest breakthrough yet. We're taking worn out batteries and making them into something strong. Energizer Eco Advanced, world's first long-lasting battery made with 4% recycled batteries.
Johnny, even after careers like ours, we're still going strong.
What's your secret, Richard?
Blue Emu.
Oh, I've used Blue Emu for over 10 years. I love their odor-free Blue Emu Continuous Pain Relief Spray.
Me too. It's got an active ingredient to relieve my muscle aches and joint pains.
And soothing emu oil for those hard-to-reach places.
I knew you was a winner.
I'm glad we had this talk.
Blue Emu, it works fast.
And you won't stink.
Van. And introducing the all-new Ram ProMaster City. Purpose-built to help you run the town. Ram.
One of the fort's favorite rituals happens at the water's edge. Here, they must look their best. Smooth, beautiful skin is an advantage. The others can only hide in shame. Introducing the new Dr. Scholl's Dreamwalk Express Petty.
Look at that beautiful hotel on TripAdvisor. Wait, why leave the site? Don't you know? The TripAdvisor you've always trusted for reviews now checks over 200 websites to find the best price. Over 200 sites checked to find the best price. So don't just visit TripAdvisor, at TripAdvisor.
Where you get your weather matters.
This is a large and dangerous tornado.
That's why we get real local the moment you need it.
We are live in Oklahoma, Arkansas, Mississippi, Florida.
Real accurate.
This is round one of the severe storms that are coming through.
From real experts on the ground.
That is a gust front for you right there in Dusty, Texas. Wow.
Where you get your weather matters.
This is basically what makes the Weather Channel.
Keep the Weather Channel on.
We're at the Weather Channel.
The Weather Channel is out in full force today.
Only the Weather Channel.
An all-new season of Fat Guys in the Woods premieres right here on the Weather Channel starting tomorrow night.
Okay, so thank you for that introduction.
Absolutely.
We wanted to know what it's like to truly survive in the wilderness. So who did we send out there?
Sam and Jim.
By no means fat guys. It's more like fit guys in the woods there.
Exactly.
But they had to spend a night with a survival expert. Take a look.
So my biggest concern, Creek, is I don't think this is even gonna go in there.
Oh my god!
Almost all.
Yeah, no kidding, right?
There's a way.
There's no way that's going in there.
Go, Bubble, go!
So this Eno is like really big. Anybody who's ever hammocked by a river or in the middle of the woods,
just pull through.
Creek, can you give me a bedtime story? That's it.
Here's to a fantastic night in the woods, man.
Bon appetit.
It's a beautiful afternoon. Cheers.
I think I'm a little bit of a snorer.
I can see you being a snorer, Cantori.
Gee, thanks, Greg. I love you too, man.
Man, I'm going to stay up all night worrying. I just hope Sam survives.
Good night, everybody.
We really missed an opportunity, Kate, that you and I did not show up there in giant bear costumes. We should have dressed up like bears and shown up there. Season 2 of Fat Guys in the Woods kicks off tomorrow night at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Sam and Jim, be on alert. Watch out with the next time you go camping.
That's right, folks.
Might just be a couple bears that show up.
Hey, yeah, we have lion, tigers, and bears of rough weather. We got hail and possible tornadoes threatening 50 million people today. Folks, you got to be ready for it.
Look at the size of those hailstones.
Goodness.
Could we see more today? Those, really dangerous. But we also have the possibility of tornadoes. That's coming up next.
What are you doing?
I'm having a small snack.
What?
Have you tried this mayonnaise? It's great.
Gross.
Don't live with ants. Get Raid Ant and Roach Spray.
Raid?
And take back your home. Raid kills bugs dead.
SC Johnson, a family company.
At WeatherTech, we never stop inventing ways to keep your vehicle protected. From
floor liners and cargo liners to dozens of other world-class quality products, including no-drill mud flaps and bump step. Nothing is better for your car, truck, or SUV than WeatherTech for your family, the whole family. Go to WeatherTech.com to find the ultimate vehicle protection, along with a full line of automotive accessories. Nothing protects like WeatherTech.
It's your thing. No matter how you want to lose weight, you can do it fast with delicious, nutritious Slim Fast. Shake it off, blend it off, drink it off. Just take it off and keep it off. Protein-packed Slim Fast controls your hunger up to 4 hours. Clinically proven to work and work fast. It's your thing. See results in just 1 week. Losing weight has never been easier with Slim Fast. It's your thing.
Currently in our area, 74 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 86. Chance of rain 60%. Tonight, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Mostly cloudy skies. Low 74. Sunday, partly cloudy. High 85. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
More than 50 million people are under the threat for severe weather this weekend, from the plains to the Ohio Valley. I'll tell you who needs to be on alert for large hail, damaging winds, and even tornadoes.
And Hurricane Blanca spinning its way toward shore, packing 120-mile-an-hour winds and setting its sights on the Baja Peninsula. We're going to time out the risk.
And what you need to be on the lookout for after that record rainfall across the southern plains and a super wet week up and down much of the East Coast. This morning, news of hidden hazards that could affect both you, your home, and your car.
Good morning, Omaha, Nebraska. 69 degrees there right now. This is a live look at Creighton University. Now, it's overcast there now, but storms in the forecast today. A Torcon of 4 in place for Omaha, and that's just one of the spots as a Torcon of 4 today. Dr. Greg Postel going to break down the latest on that severe threat in just a couple minutes, but first, good morning to you. Welcome to AMHQ Weekend, Saturday, June the 6th. I'm Kate Parker, and the gang is back.
Indeed.
I love it. I and love having the team here.
It's a three-part gang. It's not only the lovely Kate, I'm Reynolds. We also have Dr. Greg Postel. And it's also a very busy day. Dino and Dr. Greg, we're covering a lot of bases in terms of the big picture.
Yeah, big picture. One of the first stories we'll get to is the severe weather. Kate was mentioning in the northern plains, Reynolds, maybe the Dakotas. Watch out for western Minnesota and Iowa and Nebraska as well. Severe weather, a possibility, if not a likelihood there, with even some tornadoes.
Okay, so it's not just that, but we now have major Hurricane Blanca out in the east Pacific. So this was upgraded earlier on this morning. Obviously looking pretty good on satellite, but we have some news of possibly some weakening and some information ahead on that. So you want to stay tuned, especially if you have plans in Baja.
You know, the fuel to some of that fire had to be the warm ocean water, but we have warm conditions up in parts of the Pacific Northwest. Temperatures anywhere from 10 to even 30 degrees above average. 100s in the valleys. Redding, California could get up around 102. Before all is said and done.
That so looks hot. Okay, so take a look. This is one of the 4 tornadoes reported across Colorado yesterday. This is near Vona, Colorado, about 140 miles east of Denver toward Kansas there in the plains. Incredible images here. Look at the structure on that. Look at that mesocyclone. I mean, that's incredible. No damage, no serious injuries reported with this tornado. It was a sparsely populated area, but I got to tell you what, the fact that we have more storms in the forecast today is making a lot of people nervous, so we've got to get the latest, right?
Absolutely. You know, we have another weekend packed with the threat of severe weather. And you look at that video, how daunting that has been, what they've dealt with in Colorado in terms of the thunderstorms. They've had the tornadic activity, the hail. And now the setup is pretty similar for today, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. I think hail and high winds are still the dominant modes today to expect. But tornadoes are a possibility, I think, across parts of the plains, including Nebraska, even western Iowa and eastern South Dakota. That area shaded in red, that's the area most likely to see severe weather today. Right now, we don't have any severe thunderstorm warnings out there. We have a flash flood warning out here for parts of northern Kansas. That's Republican Washington counties. But notice that the cluster of storms has already moved through that area. It's right out in here and closing in on Kansas City and St. Joe Mo. So watch out. We got some big storms rolling through that will certainly maybe delay your tea time if you're thinking about going out there in the next couple hours. So watch out for that. Then you'll get a break, and then we'll see new storms develop, I think, later on today farther north in the plains. The surface wind pattern is kind of complicated. We got some very dry air coming out of the northeast, cool high pressure over the Great Lakes. It's along this boundary right now that those storms are forming, and they'll be moving along that way. So they're setting up the train tracks right now for movement about like that. That's why Kansas City is in line. But later today, that front is going to be lifting back toward the north as a warm front, and we'll see new development along it later on this afternoon, where the winds aloft near the jet stream level, 30,000 feet or so, are quite a bit stronger, in excess of 50 miles per hour, closer to 100 miles per hour in spots. Look at where the models are showing up. The new storm develops across parts of South Dakota, Nebraska. By about 4:30 this afternoon, all along that zone, big thunderstorms are likely. Fargo, Sioux Falls, North Platte, Omaha, everywhere in between, even the possibility of a tornado or two. Reynolds and Kate, back to you.
Okay, so that's the threat today, right, Dr. Postel? But what about looking toward tomorrow and your Monday? Pittsburgh. Now, you're a little bit cloudy this morning, but you have some sunny skies on the way. Actually, pretty nice weekend weather. But Sunday night, it's a big change. So here's a current look at the satellite. Here are the clouds that I was just mentioning. We've got a little bit of rain north of Baltimore right now. Take a look at New York City. Long Island, you've got that rain still on the Long Island Expressway there. That was shut down earlier this week because of flash flooding. Right now, winds are calm, mostly cloudy. We're starting to see a clearing out at Central Park. Nearly 2/10 of an inch of rain has already fallen this morning. This along a front that's slowly going to scoot offshore today. So improving forecasts for much of the northeast through the morning. It is going to move a little farther south, some of this precipitation, thanks to just that pumping in of that warm weather. So the Delmarva, you could see a couple of those thunderstorms. DC, you could see a couple later on this evening as you make those evening plans. I know a lot of kids in town seeing the Smithsonian and the Capitol. Well, you may want to pay attention to the weather, not just today. Today, though, heading into tomorrow. Here's where that next cold front sweeps with that nice moist flow right out of the south. Heading into Monday, that's where we're going to watch the severe threat shift. So this is for your Sunday. Okay, so we were just talking about the threat today. This is for Sunday, Detroit, on down south into Indiana. Going into Monday, you'll notice this shifts farther off to the east, and this is going to include places like New York and then an area that's more across Pennsylvania, West Virginia, Kentucky, and even back into the boot heel of Missouri. You have on Monday lingering risk of severe weather, Reynolds.
Oh, some rough stuff there. Possibly some rough stuff across parts of the deep south, too, where we've got some showers and storms and maybe the mix. High humidity, moisture content in the atmosphere. You've got plenty of a dew point high, temperatures mainly in the 60s and 70s. That frontal boundary that's going to march its way to the south is going to interact with that moisture, forcing it higher aloft where it'll condense, form those showers, the storms. Not the same kind of severe weather setup that we're going to have out in parts of the central plains or in the upper Midwest, but still, you can't rule out a chance of some boomers popping up, maybe a few even into the evening. For the deep south, well, you saw the showers there, but in Florida, the very deep south, it's going to be more of the sea breeze activity that's going to cause things to fire up, not only in places like Jacksonville, Orlando, but in Tampa and Naples. As we cruise away from the morning hours into the afternoon, those showers are going to become far more numerous and possibly quite loud, even down towards Bud and Mary's in Alamorada, where the skiff boats are getting ready to go out. Maybe the 8-weight, maybe the 10-weight fly rod going after the bonefish. By the afternoon, you may be catching some storms. They could be rather strong at times. Kate?
Okay, Reynolds, here's a really quick update on Hurricane Blanca. Now, this is a Category 3 hurricane, 120 mile an hour winds. Notice a nice structure on this. We've got that really clear eye. We've got that those very high cloud tops around the center of this. This did strengthen a little bit overnight, but we're anticipating it to weaken as we go throughout the next couple of days. We've got a full forecast on Blanca, Reynolds, coming up in just a couple minutes.
Thanks so much, Kate. You know, sometimes you find yourself in a really scary situation. That was the case of a storm chaser in Colorado who got too close to a tornado. Hear and see what happened to him coming up. That story moments away.
Hey, what are you playing?
Tyler's 3.
Gotcha.
Come on. Yeah, that will work.
Golfsmith. Anything for golf.
Let's do this. Let's build a dining room with no walls. Let's put it all together. Then let's get together. Let's do this. Plant color everywhere with 12-pack annuals, just $9.98. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
The Honda ATV clearance event is going on now, which means it's your time to ride red and save green. Your Honda dealer is offering incredible deals on America's best-selling ATV lineup, the Rugged Rancher, Dependable Foreman, and Trail Hungry Rubicon. Right now, get up to $500 in bonus bucks on select models and fixed financing rates as low as 2.99%. So if you're ready to ride red and save serious green, then head to the Honda ATV clearance event today.
If you've been wishing for something amazing, at Cricket Wireless, we've got it. A special offer on the new Samsung Galaxy S6. Plus, we've got more 4G LTE coverage nationwide than T-Mobile or Sprint. Because a great phone deserves a great network. Cricket Wireless, something to smile about.
One of the Foots' favorite rituals happens at the water's edge. Here, they must look their best. Smooth, beautiful skin is an advantage. The others can only hide in shame. Introducing the new Dr. Scholl's Dreamwalk Express Petty.
Are you a man over 40 and feeling tired, losing muscle, have less romantic drive? Then you need Ageless Male, with an ingredient clinically shown to increase free testosterone levels. Ageless Male is now available at these fine retailers.
The Weather Channel's most watched original program,
and it just hit us,
is back.
This is just the beginning of what's to come.
Currently in our area, 74 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 86. Chance of rain 60%. Tonight, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Mostly cloudy skies. Low 74. Sunday, partly cloudy. High 85. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Big time.
Let's get this thing right.
I have made fire!
Fat Guys in the Woods. New season starts tomorrow, only on the Weather Channel.
Come to your television and check this out. Now watch and listen as the storm chaser in Colorado has a very close call with the tornado.
Yep, got hit by a flying horse trailer. Right now I'm getting hit by baseball hail watching the tornado, but yeah, the whole topper is gone off my truck. The winds ripped it right off the back of my truck.
This happened in Simla. That's a town in parts of Colorado, about 60 miles southeast of Denver as the crow flies, and that call made right after the funnel just missed his car. Thankfully, he did manage to survive. Shaken up, obviously, but certainly scary times. And then this out of Denver, no, that is not snow. That is hail covering much of the city street. Storms moved through Denver on Thursday, dumping several inches of hail in the area. Also brought with it 50-mile-per-hour winds. Several homes were damaged. Now taking a live look at Denver, you can expect some scattered showers and storms lasting all the way through the weekend. Temperatures going up in the upper 70s, and you might even deal with about a quarter inch of rainfall. Shall we time it out for you? Why the heck not? Let's take a look at what you can expect in Denver. Notice that we're going to have the clouds, some sunshine making an appearance by 11 a.m. By 1 p.m., it's going to stick around. And then take a look who shows up by the time 5 p.m. comes calling. Hit or miss storms. Some of those may be severe. You could have some hail, could have some heavy rain, can't rule out a tornado, but more than anything, going to have the flash, the boom of those thunderstorms and the heavy rain that will come down at times. All right, let's send it over to Kate.
Now, Reynolds, whether it's the heavy rain, the hail, or the wind, homes are just taking a beating from Mother Nature this spring. And one of the most vulnerable areas of the home is the roof. So joining us now this morning from Rosie's Restoration, based in Atlanta, is roofing expert Dr. Charlie Yood. Dr. Yood, this has been a pretty incredible super soaker for a lot of places across the country so far this spring. First, let's talk about rain. What kind of impact does it have on our roofs?
Well, if you have a healthy roof, heavy rain really doesn't matter. So this is an opportunity for homeowners to find out if they do have a healthy roof or not. For even a small leak can lead to some pretty serious damage on the inside.
How do you check your roof after days and days of heavy rain? Or is that something pretty obvious that you'll know when you have a leak?
Well, you can do it before, during, and after. Before a storm, you might actually get into your attic and turn out the lights and look at places where the pipes pass through the ceiling. If you see light coming in from around the pipes, very often you can have water there too. Now, during a rainstorm, a homeowner can get in the attic and look for active leaks. And then after a storm, it's a good idea to walk around your house and look at the ceilings in closets for evidence of active leaks.
Okay, so we've seen baseball-size hail this week across the U.S. You know, that's falling on your roof, you're inside. It can be nail-biting because you know it's doing damage. What kind of damage do we see from hail?
Well, when a hailstone hits a roof, so for instance, a golf ball-size hail hits a roof, it will damage the granules and fracture the fiberglass mat. Now, this is called bruising, and when you have a crack in the mat, it allows water to get in, and this creates leaks.
Okay, so that's pretty serious. You get up to baseball size hail. Is there any chance that you could see that go through your roof?
Actually, in some instances, it will go through the roof and damage the wood underneath it. So yes, that is something that can happen.
Okay, so what should a homeowner do right after a hailstorm whenever you see damage like what we're looking at on our screen?
Well, sometimes the damage isn't that obvious. So any homeowner can go out after a hailstorm and inspect the soft metal on their property. So gutters, siding, window wraps, look for evidence of hail damage. And if they find that, then they should get their roof inspected so they don't have to go on the roof themselves.
And wind damage is also something that we look at and pretty significant. Can that damage your roof?
Almost as much as hail. So wind will actually tear off shingles sometimes. And if you're missing a shingle, you have an active leak at that moment. But wind can also cause the shingle to flap and not remove the shingle. That lets wind-driven rain get under that shingle and leak through the fasteners. So that needs to be checked by a qualified individual as well.
Okay, thank you so much, Dr. Yood, for joining us this morning. This is obviously information that you just need this time of year because it can just be horrifying whenever you hear your roof being torn apart while you're inside your home. Okay, moving on to another type of danger. What if you could safely simulate Category 5 hurricane winds?
What sounds perplexing? Let me guess, there is some kind of machine that can do that very thing, Kate. It's got to be. This one! Yeah, that machine is the first test tank that can do that very thing. Coming up, how this hurricane machine will help communities prepare for the very worst.
And Hurricane Blanca making waves in the Pacific. This is going to be moving toward Cabo San Lucas. You know, Reynolds, it's wedding season.
It is.
Every day, you know it. In your Facebook feed, you have all those wedding photos popping up. But where are they honeymooning? Maybe Cabo San Lucas?
Probably not a good thing. Hey, this is a good thing, though. Beautiful times in St. Louis. Now, on the other side of the state, you don't have the blue skies. You have the approaching severe weather. But St. Louis right now looks pretty darn good. Three-day forecast shows thunder boomers moving into that city, the gateway to the west, by Monday.
Yeah, Monday morning we could see some of that. So we've got a lot of that going on. Okay, take a look at this picture. We can't get these unless you send them in. So thank you for sharing this with us. Hawthorne, Nevada. Look at this. Some storm damage there. That looks like a piece of a roof up there in the power line.
Unbelievable. All right, folks. Skip, thanks so much for seeing in that picture. We're going to show you, again, many more things of what to expect around the country, plus hopefully your pictures. Send them on in. We'll share them with America.
Looks like the Garcias got a new car.
What'd they get?
I don't know.
Sure doesn't look like a Buick.
Buick.
I'm outside. Where are you?
I'm right here. I'm in the Buick.
I don't see a Buick.
Take a fresh look at Buick. It just might surprise you.
That's not a Buick. That's what I told him.
Wow. This is nice.
Oh, my.
Now get nearly $7,200 total value on specially equipped 2015 Enclave models.
Introducing the first ever gummy multivitamin from Centrum. A complete and tasty new way to support your energy, immunity, and metabolism like never before. Centrum Multigummies. See gummies in a whole new light.
Next.
Ah,
wait time, 55 minutes. Your call is important to us. Thank you for your patience.
In the nation, we know how it feels when you aren't treated like a priority. We do things differently.
We'll take care of it.
We put members first.
Thank you.
Join the nation.
Nationwide is on your side.
Time to sweat, boys. Big time.
Let's get this thing right.
I have made fire!
Fat Guys in the Woods. New season starts tomorrow. Only on the Weather Channel.
If you're not happy with how your allergy medicine treats your congestion, rethink relief with Nasacort Allergy 24-Hour. Unlike antihistamines that target only one cause of your symptoms, Nasacort stops more, relieving the worst nasal allergy symptoms, even congestion, for 24 hours. It's non-addictive and has no harsh taste, and unlike Flonase, it's scent and alcohol-free. And it's available over-the-counter at full prescription strength. Rethink your relief with Nasacort. It stops more of what makes you miserable.
If you want a great lawn, you can spend hours every week mowing, weeding, fertilizing, or experience a greener world with Synthetic Turf International. Spend time enjoying your lawn, not working on it. Experience a greener world with Synthetic Turf International.
Weather Channel's most watched original program.
And it just hit us.
Is back.
This is just the beginning of what's to come.
Currently in our area, 74 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 86. Chance of rain 60%. Tonight, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Mostly cloudy skies. Low 74. Sunday, partly cloudy. High 85. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
The Weather Channel is Hurricane Central, and we have some activity in the tropics to tell you about in just a few moments. But first, what really does happen during a Category 5 hurricane? Well, that's exactly what some researchers are finding out with a one-of-a-kind hurricane simulator. David Hodges from NBC2 News in Southwest Florida gives us an inside look at a simulator that's called Sustain.
It's a fitting name for the ultimate goal. Use this hurricane simulator and learn how to withstand a Category 5 hurricane.
So we can have more resilient communities here in South Florida and the rest of the world's coastlines.
Dr. Brian House is director of the new tank at the University of Miami. He says Sustain is the first tank that can simulate a Cat 5 hurricane. With 1,400 horsepower fans, it generates winds more than 150 miles per hour. House says don't even think about stepping inside then.
No, there's no way you could be able, you would be blown, certainly blown through the back of the system.
And that makes it just like a real hurricane. He says it will give them better data about what type of structures stand up to these high winds and how pollutants like oil spread across the ocean during a storm.
So that if there's another spill event, the resources can be targeted in the best way to handle them.
The tank is made of acrylic. It's completely see-through from all sides. House is hoping it will also give his team a glimpse of how to handle future storms.
We need to learn how to build better or else we're not going to be able to continue to thrive here in South Florida.
Well, folks in Cabo San Lucas, a little on edge this morning. Understandably so, as Hurricane Blanca continues to spin towards shore, and now they're under a tropical storm watch. Now, this video that you're seeing is from Hurricane Odile. That's what it did last year in September. Keep in mind, that was also a Category 3. Kate Parker and Dr. Greg Postel are in the lab right now with more on Hurricane Blanca.
Yeah, you know, Reynolds, you see that, and it makes you really nervous whenever you look at the satellite picture of Blanca, you know, but there are some different characteristics than what we saw with Odile. I don't think we're expecting this to be an Odile situation in the Baja.
Unlikely, right, because this is not as strong, and it's going to be weakening on approach to Baja during the next 36 hours. Let's look at the latest stats from the Hurricane Center. It is estimated to have winds at about 120 miles per hour, but that may be on the conservative side based on a lot of the satellite data that's coming in. So it may be stronger than that. The hurricane hunters will be in there, I think, later on this afternoon. So we'll let you know exactly how strong it is as soon as we get that information. But they're a buck 20 moving northwest at 12. That's like that. That should keep the center and the core of the hurricane force winds, off the coast. Southern Baja.
I mean, we're still going to see impacts along the entire west coast of Mexico because you've got the wave issue. You've got those winds that are sitting just offshore. And I mean, that's going to be pushing those waves onshore. Rip current risk is going to go up. You could see some beach erosion. But what is the deal with the rain? What's the deal with these hurricane force winds? What are they going to do? Are people at risk in the Baja?
Yeah, we'll get some heavy showers probably moving through late tonight and tomorrow, and some of those could produce those gusty winds, probably in excess of 40 to 50 miles per hour, but not a whole lot higher than that. It is going to be, I think, far enough offshore to limit the significant damage that comes with those high hurricane force winds. Those will likely be offshore. But we do have a hurricane watch in effect for parts of the eastern Baja, including Cabo San Lucas. But that's just on the possibility that there'll be hurricane conditions there, not the likelihood. It's more likely that those will be offshore because the models, the consensus is for this to go the center about 150 miles to the west of there. But then it continues northward, Kate.
Well, it still looks like a lot of moisture, a lot of rain coming down in the Baja, but all of that has to go somewhere, right?
Right. It's going to be moving along that way and then eventually that way. So some clouds and some of the moisture will get from Baja, the impacts we think will be tomorrow, into parts of the southwest U.S. And we think probably some enhanced rainfall totals moving into Arizona and New Mexico Tuesday, Wednesday. So watch out for that. Look at this blob of moisture coming in from the Pacific into the desert southwest.
Lake Mead really wanting some of that moisture. So that's some good news there.
Here's some of the rainfall totals spit out from some of the models, and they are in excess of 1 to 2 inches. That's a lot for the desert southwest. There could be some flooding issues. Stay tuned for that. That could be a big story coming
Zion
by the middle
National
of
Park usually floods pretty easily there. So if you have some hiking adventures next week, keep that in mind.
Indeed.
Okay, Reynolds, back to you.
All right, guys, thanks so much. We'll still ahead on AMHQ weekend. Large baseball-sized hailstones like this are possible today. Can you believe that? Look at the size of those things. It's crazy. Could see them all the way from Kansas up to Minnesota. We're going to time out the worst impacts hour by hour when each city will deal with the rough storms through the weekend. Plus, the rising Red River forcing hundreds out of their homes this weekend in Louisiana. Preparations are underway as we speak. We're going to let you know when it's expected to crest. That's coming up in a few moments. But first, take a look at the shot. Portland, Oregon, warm day today. We'll tell you about that forecast in a few moments.
It's easy to buy insurance and forget about it. But the more you learn about your coverage, the more gaps you may find.
Like how you thought you were covered for this.
It's a profound statement.
But you're not even covered for this.
It's a profound statement.
Or how you may be covered for this, but not for something like this. Talk to farmers and see what gaps could be hiding in your coverage.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Johnny, even after careers like ours, we're still going strong.
What's your secret, Richard?
Blue MU's got an active ingredient to relieve my muscle aches and joint pains. Blue MU, it works fast.
And you won't stink.
One of the fort's favorite rituals happens at the water's edge. Here, they must look their best. Smooth, beautiful skin is an advantage. The others can only hide in shame. Introducing the new Dr. Scholl's Dreamwalk Express Petty.
My budget was always second-guessing me when I'd buy stuff for the family. Fingerhut. 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 At Fingerhut.com, we can shop with low monthly payments and over 200,000 items and growing from brands like Samsung, Lego, and KitchenAid. Just click on over to Fingerhut.com to get the credit you deserve and great stuff for your family. Oh, not Fingerhut. I got that at a garage sale.
for a dollar.
At the Barrett Jackson Auto Auction, cars like these can go for a cool million easy. How? It starts with the details, and nobody does details like new Barrett Jackson Premium Auto Care. Liquid wax, formulated for a Barrett Jackson quality finish with advanced polymer technology for unbeatable protection and a residue-free shine, making your car look like a cool million by the people who know cars that look like a cool million. Try new Barrett Jackson Premium Liquid Car Wax, available at Walmart.
Thank Dad at the Men's Warehouse Father's Favorites Designer Sale. Select designer suits are on sale for $229.99. All lucky jeans are two for $100. Plus, buy one, get one free on even more, including clearance. Only at Men's Warehouse.
Bop, 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 bop. Glad you're with us right here on AMHQ. The whole team.
Right, either go all in or just tap out.
Here we go. I told you, we're going to bust out of this drought.
As we say, keep watching with us this morning because we're all watching history happen together.
Currently in our area, 74 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunder. High 86. Chance of rain 60%. Tonight, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Mostly cloudy skies. Low 74. Sunday, partly cloudy. High 85. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Fat Guys in the Woods. New season starts tomorrow on the Weather Channel.
We actually saw the tornado from our front porch.
This thing has gotten much bigger. This is a large tornado now.
There it is! We have touchdown, people!
Complete shock, because we've never seen anything like that here before.
It's like someone took a giant top hat and wrote down little sheets of paper all kinds of weather phenomena that you could have in parts of Colorado and then sprinkle them all out, and that's what you had. You had hail, you had tornadoes, you had all kinds of rough weather. And even we had, a sinkhole in parts of Colorado. Folks, welcome back to AMHQ Weekend. Colorado getting hammered with so much hail and tornadoes the last couple of days. Guys, we have Kate Park with us and Dr. Postel. I'm Reynolds Wolf. What a story to tell.
It is. It's a tremendous story, and you know, a lot of people are going to be trying to clean up today. 10 reports of tornadoes since Thursday in Colorado. So their tornado season really is living up to its name.
Yeah, busy times. I mean, this is really the stormy time of the year. We've seen it weekend after weekend. Today, we'll catch a little bit of a break in parts of the country, but we'll see severe weather in the middle. You see where that area in red is in the sort of roundup, the Saturday snapshot. But I like the cool high pressure in the Great Lakes. How do you think about that? 71 in Chicago. Oh, yeah. 92 in Dallas. So you got it all, right? You have summer and actually some pretty cool weather in the Great Lakes.
Yeah, absolutely. Unfortunately, in Colorado, we do have thunder. Storms in the forecast again today, and it's a cleanup day for this Saturday, 2 days after severe storms swept through northern Colorado. Now, there were at least 25 homes that were damaged in Larimer and Boulder counties. This is a look at some of them. This, folks, is why we tell you to get in the lowest level of your home away from windows, because you'll notice in this particular home, that's the only part that's not damaged. The roof completely torn off there. So away from windows, interior room, it is a lot safer place for you to be. Fortunately, with these tornadoes, no serious injuries. That is some good news. We want to prevent that from happening as we go throughout the next couple days as well. So let's get you up to date.
My goodness. I mean, it really is a mess. And right now you just see confetti of the damage all over the countryside. Any chance we'd see that kind of situation unfold again today, Dr. Gray?
Yeah, I think there is that chance, especially across the northern plains. Look at the areas shaded in red that we've got here. Yes. Hail and high winds, Reynolds, will be the primary mode, but a tornado can't be ruled out. We have some of the ingredients in place for that, all the way from Fargo down through parts of eastern Colorado. Right now, monitoring a cluster of storms that has moved through southern Nebraska and northern Kansas. There it is right there. But guess what? There's a flash flood warning that's still in effect behind it. That's because of the watershed areas are still filling up with the runoff, and that's in Republic and Washington counties in Kansas. But also, look out Kansas City. We got some rumblers moving through. No severe weather here. But lightning and maybe a couple of gusty winds out of the northwest, maybe 20 miles per hour, something like that. Really not too bad, but it might delay some of your morning plans if you had expected drier conditions. And they'll be out of your hair in a couple hours, but there may be more later on today. That frontal zone right there, this is a stationary boundary, not moving much. It's kind of separating the dry northeasterly wind and east-northeast wind there from a more humid southerly wind here. But it's kind of setting up the train track, so to speak, for the storms that are in place now, which are right here. And you can sort of get the sense that you know where they're going to go. They're going to follow that front and go that way. But later on today, we'll see everything shift on farther to the north, thanks in part to stronger winds aloft, way up here, top of the ridge. There'll be ridge riders today, big storms that form right along this zone and roll on that direction across parts of the Dakotas and Minnesota. Let's time it out now for everybody, showing you. There we go. Fargo. Look at that. Sioux Falls all the way down to North Platte and Omaha, Nebraska. These guys could be some severe makers as well with hail and high winds and maybe even the possibility of a tornado. And that's going to last likely through the late evening and overnight hours. And then we'll see transition to a high wind threat, maybe getting into parts of the Western Lakes. Kate, back to you.
Okay, Dr. Postel in Louisiana, the National Weather Service says that the Red River is rising higher than it has in nearly 70 years. It is now at major flood stage. Officials there expect the Red River to crest at more than 36 feet on Sunday. So with us on the phone right now is Bossier Parish Sheriff Julian Whittington. Good morning to you.
Good morning to you.
Okay, so we've been hearing about some evacuations taking place. I believe a trailer park, a mobile home has been, the area has been evacuated. What other evacuations are going on right now?
Well, so far about 75 homes have been affected. That includes the RV park, and hopefully that we can stop it at that. But if it continues to rise to the anticipated, you know, 36.5 that they're telling us, in Bossier we kind of suffer immediate flood, the river flowing over the banks, and then what we call the southern part of the parish, about four tributaries all try to get into the Red River, and that's a slow backup effect. It's totally different than what we've been dealing with this week. So we have the immediate flooding, and then we're watching for the, you know, the backwater flooding as it crests tomorrow night, supposedly.
Right. So even this immediate flooding, it's still kind of not so, it's not flash flooding, because this is all along the Red River, and this is all water that fell in Oklahoma and Texas and has been flowing into Louisiana. So we are expecting that water to still increase. Like you were saying, the crest 36.5 feet possibly tomorrow. Are there sandbagging efforts going on? What are people trying to do to stop this water?
Yes, actually, we've had inmates and with the parish officials here, and we've been making sandbags and placing sandbags 24/7 for about a week and a half now. So, you know, a lot of people are trying to save their homes. Others have said, you know, there's no way. Let's get out.
Okay, so have you been seeing? Obviously, we've been looking at some video here. Have you been seeing many homes that are inundated with water?
Probably this morning, we probably have 15 or 20 that actually have water in them, and several more that, you know, by the crest time tomorrow night, we'll have water in them.
Okay, thank you so much for coming to us. That's Sheriff Julian Whittington from Bossier Parish in Louisiana with the Red River flooding. We're going to talk more about the severe weather risk that we have going on this weekend when we come back.
Amore.
Subito.
All-new Fiat 500X crossover. Bigger, more powerful, and ready for action.
I've got plans. And this is my baby right now. So it's just not the right time to get pregnant.
That's why I chose Skyla.
Skyla is the small, flexible IUD that prevents pregnancy for up to 3 years. So for me, there are no daily pills or monthly refills.
I got my Skyla placed in just a few minutes at my OBGYN's office. And if I want to try to get pregnant, I can get it removed whenever I want.
If you have a pelvic infection, get infections easily, or have certain cancers, don't use Skyla. Less than 1% of users get a serious infection called PID. If you have persistent pelvic or stomach pain, or if Skyla comes out, tell your doctor. Skyla may attach or go through the uterus and cause other problems. Pregnancy while using Skyla is uncommon, but can be life-threatening and may result in loss of pregnancy or fertility. Ovarian cysts may occur, but usually disappear. Bleeding and spotting may increase in the first 3 to 6 months and remain irregular. Periods over time usually become shorter, lighter, or may stop. Skyla does not protect against HIV or STDs.
Talk to your OBGYN about making the move to Skyla.
Check with your insurance to find out if you can get Skyla at no cost.
Let's do this. Let's move outdoors for the next few months. Let's build a kitchen under the clouds. A dining room with no walls, no ceiling. Let's put it all together. Then, let's get together. A lot. Let's do this. Plant color everywhere with 12-pack annuals, just $9.98. The Home Depot. More saving. More doing.
Are you a man over 40 and feeling tired? Losing muscle? Have less romantic drive? Then you need Ageless Male, with an ingredient clinically shown to increase free testosterone levels. Ageless Male is now available at these fine retailers.
So if you were me, what would you do next?
Start another business, build another website.
Hmm. Hey, Heidi Heiss, Heidi Lowe's. Heidi Weissen.
So 2014.
That's it.
With Wix, it's easy to create your own stunning website.
Heidi Whitey's.
You did this all by yourself?
Want to try them on?
Go to Wix and create your site today.
Currently in our area, 75 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High, 86. Chance of rain, 60%. Tonight, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Mostly cloudy skies. Low, 74. Sunday, partly cloudy. High, 85. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Welcome back. Live look at Chicago. Beautiful day for you. A little bit of a chilly start, perfect for a morning run. But here's the deal. This afternoon, you've got sunshine, gorgeous looking forecast, but we need you to be ready for Sunday. So get all those outdoor chores done today, because this is what it looks like as we head into tomorrow. You have the risk of thunderstorms returning to the forecast. Take a look at this. There they are, through the morning, into the afternoon, through the overnight. It's going to be hit or miss overnight, but during the afternoon and evening hours, I think right whenever you're making those dinner plans, maybe doing some outdoor grilling, maybe whatever you have planned, you need to cancel it, or you at least need to have a backup plan, because the risk of severe weather is in play. Look along I-70 tomorrow. That's really where we're going to see the risk of severe weather, and then stretching up from Chicago into South Bend, Indiana, and then going on into Michigan, actually, we have the risk of not just damaging hail and high winds, but an isolated tornado, not out of the question. Look at your forecast with the Torcons here. Tomorrow in Chicago, a Torcon of 3. This is through the evening and even overnight hours, so you have to have something to wake you up at night. A weather radio, whatever will get you up and get your family safe. Madison, Wisconsin, it's the same deal in the overnight. And then Grand Rapids, the evening and overnight, once again an issue. 30% chance of seeing a tornado within 50 miles of those locations. Here's the cold front that's going to be the culprit for thunderstorms heading into Monday as well. You'll notice through in Cleveland, the Ohio River Valley, and then down into Lexington, Poplar Bluff even, and then the Missouri Boot Heel. You're going to see some thunderstorms as you head into Monday. And then going into the northeast, you have that risk as well. Along the front, warm front, we might see a couple thunderstorms on that leading edge. And then down along the cold front, we'll see a few as well. This includes the nation's capital, places like New York City, Boston. You're going to be wet on Monday night, and you could even see some of those strong to severe thunderstorms, so we're concerned about that as we head into the next couple of days. In fact, look at Monday as you're heading back to work in Nashville, in D.C., in New York. It's not just your thunderstorm risk, it's the risk of severe weather coming into play. So Reynolds, that's obviously something we're planning ahead for in the coming days.
Absolutely, all kinds of stuff possible, including flooding. And you know, flooding has been a big issue. And over the last couple of weeks, we've actually seen hundreds of cars submerged in those floodwaters. And many of those cars, not headed to junkyards. Instead, they're going to very shady sellers trying to get unsuspecting buyers trying to take advantage of them. Well, joining us live right now is our friend and yours, Lauren Fix, car coach Lauren Fix, on how to spot some of those flood damaged vehicles. Thanks for getting up so early with us. Lauren, quick question for you. The Car Care Council has issued guidelines on how to check these cars. What are some things we need to be careful about?
Well, one of the big things is we call them curbstoners. These are people that park their cars in the corner and it says for sale. And the price looks really good. And so we're going to give you some tips. So before you purchase these cars, please have them checked out by an ASE certified technician. Listen, if it feels too good, walk away. That's like the bottom line of the whole thing. But there's a lot of things you can do yourself. And it's really easy to do.
Well, Lauren, aren't there some kind of laws, some kind of fines that can help protect the consumer in that kind of situation?
Believe it or not, there are no fines. You would think the insurance company would say, we take the car off, you know, off the road, it goes to a salvager, and then finally you see it again on a street corner. Believe it or not, this happens all the time. From Katrina and Rita, we had the same problem, and here we are again with more flooding going on all across the country, and it could be anywhere. And people think, well, that's only if you live down south. Believe me, these cars have made it all the way to Canada. They've made it all around the world. From just the previous flooding, we had 650,000 cars on the road, and you really need to be buyer beware careful.
Okay, so you've told us if a deal's too good to be true, it probably isn't true. Also,
true.
We've got to be watching out for ourselves because there are no laws or fines to help protect the consumer. What are some of the things that we need to look out for when examining these cars?
Well, the first thing I always do is you can pop the hood. If the car is, you know, a 2010 or a 2005, anything that's from 2000 and newer, and you pop the hood on the car, which anyone can do, look at it. Do you see moisture underneath the fuse box? Do you see rust in unusual places on top of the engine? Places that don't make sense. Do you look under the car and see all kinds of mud and grass and maybe some rust in areas that just don't make sense to you? Well, that little inkling is correct. Also in the interior, if you see mismatched interiors, those are real high, big clues to look for.
Isn't she great? Lauren Fix, the car coach. Thanks so much for your time this morning. All right, folks,
thank
coming
you.
Up ahead on MHQ Weekend, Hurricane Blanca. Now a major hurricane again, Kate.
Yeah, we're going to be taking a look at Cabo San Lucas, and the threat there could be an early landfall.
It starts with a subtle wave, then builds into soft fingers, lifting sails and spirits. Nothing makes us feel more alive than a summer breeze. Drifting with us on the water, chasing us through the trees, and playing along the whole day. In the Great Lakes Bay region, the summer breeze is blowing. Where it's headed is pure Michigan. Your trip begins at Michigan.org.
Started my Camry. Remembered the choices I've made. To be bold where others are scared. To show her right from wrong. And realized my little girl had become an amazing human being. Who will make choices of her own. Toyota. Let's go places.
Are you still getting heartburn flare-ups? Time for a new routine. Try Nexium 24 Hour, the latest choice for frequent heartburn. Get complete protection. Nexium Level Protection.
Dads who would do anything for golf deserve a store that would do anything for dads. Visit Golfsmith for the best Father's Day gifts at the guaranteed lowest prices. Golfsmith, anything for golf.
The Weather Channel's most watched original program.
And it just hit us.
Is back.
This is just the beginning of what's to come.
Things move fast around here.
Who's got time to look at the fine print? So you see DirecTV's new offer. $19, you think. But after just 3 months, you're paying over $100 a month, and it keeps going up. Turns out you're locked into a 2-year contract that could cost you nearly $3,000. Thinking about DirecTV? Think again.
Don't fall for DirecTV's latest offer. There's nothing direct about DirecTV.
When irritated, itchy summer skin holds me back, I count on Cortisone 10 Intensive Healing. With the strongest non-prescription itch medicine available for fast, long-lasting relief. And 7 moisturizers to help heal skin. Cortisone 10. Feel the heal.
When I have an eczema flare-up, I start to scratch. The more I scratch, the worse it gets. It's maddening.
Gold Bond Eczema Relief Cream. Used daily, it's proven to relieve 5 frustrating symptoms of eczema.
Gold Bond Eczema Relief really works.
Currently in our area, 75 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon, high 86, chance of rain 60%. Tonight, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Mostly cloudy skies, low 74. Sunday, partly cloudy, high 85. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Back everyone to AMHQ Weekend. Keeping a sharp eye on these storms moving to the southeast at 30 miles per hour. They pack quite a bit of rain, lightning with it, bringing the boom, bringing the moisture to places like Leavenworth. You take a look at how we've got this panned out, moving through the communities of Soldier, Leavenworth, Lansing, Lawrence, and Kansas City. Kansas City by 8:03, preceded by the heavy wind. Then you have the rain droplets, the heavier activity coming through. Folks flash flooding places with poor drainage. You might see the water begin to pile up. Certainly could be the first sign of a troublesome day across parts of the Midwest. Let's send it back to Kate and Dr. Bosell. They are in the lab.
Yeah, we got to get you the very latest on the tropics. You know, it is 50 past the hour. We've got a now major Hurricane Blanca, once again a major hurricane, and it looks like it's heading toward the Baja Peninsula.
It's going to get close. There's no doubt about that. 120 miles per hour on the wind speed, as you said, Kate, but it may be stronger than that. Some of the satellite estimates coming in suggest that number is a little conservative. Mm-hmm. Moving northwest at 12, this is good news because that is probably going to bring the core west by at least 100 miles or so of Cabo San Lucas, likely tomorrow. So they'll still get some impacts, mm-hmm. but not the core, the worst of it. That should remain offshore.
Okay, well, that's good news, but, you know, this is looking pretty fierce. So are we expecting? I mean, obviously, we're still seeing some impacts from this, from winds pushing the water, giving us some pretty big waves. But, you know, is this going to stay an impactful system as it nears that resort community?
Not as much as it is now for a couple of reasons. One, the ocean water temperatures are cooler that mm-hmm. far north. And two, the atmosphere is not quite as supportive either as it is now. So let's have a look, though. With all that in mind, still, we have hurricane watches and tropical storm warnings out for parts of southern Baja. And there we go. You can see how it is right in here. You see that? We have hurricane watches for the possibility, not likelihood, but possibility of hurricane conditions there and tropical storm warnings around the rest of the southern tip of Baja for the likelihood of tropical storm force winds in excess of 40 miles per hour.
So this is making a lot of people nervous, especially as this wedding season, a lot of people are honeymooning and they want to look at every model run and what these computers are saying. So, you know, this is still looking pretty sketchy that we could still have some pretty significant winds.
You're exactly right, Kate. The consensus is that the center will be over here somewhere, probably along that zone, 100 plus miles to the west of Cabo, but it's a pretty big storm, so watch out for the possibility, as you mentioned, of some maybe outer rain bands coming in along that way, bringing winds maybe 40 to 50 miles per hour at times with some gusty showers as well. This is kind of what we think it'll look like during the next 24 to 36 hours as it moves on off toward the northwest, kind of skirting southern Baja, but then the moisture gets into the southwest U.S. We'll talk about that coming up at 20 past the hour. Stay tuned for all the latest.
That's some good news.
How about that?
Great weekend destinations brought to you by Bush's Beans. What's your favorite flavor?
One can of Bush's Beans. Home style sounds good, but country style not without its charms. Brown sugar hickory? Who says no to hickory? New sweet heat? Sure! There are no rules here.
Bush's Beans. What's your favorite flavor?
Attention, did you or anyone in your household work around asbestos-containing gaskets and packing? The Garlock bankruptcy may affect your rights even if you do not presently have an asbestos-related disease. Garlock's products were used in industrial and maritime settings where steam, hot liquid, or acid moved in pipes. Certain personal injury claims must be filed by October 6, 2015. You may have a right to vote on Garlock's plan to reorganize and pay claims. Call 844-GARLOCK or go to garlocknotice.com.
Andrew, Rita, Sandy. Meet Chris, Jackie, Joe. Minor damage or major disaster. When you need us most, we're there. State Farm. We're a force of nature, too.
What are you doing in here?
I'm grooming.
Is that my toothbrush?
Yes. How about a little privacy?
Don't live with roaches. Get Raid Ant and Roach Spray.
Raid?
And take back your home. Raid kills bugs dead.
SC Johnson, a family company.
The Honda ATV clearance event is going on now, which means it's your time to ride red and save green. Your Honda dealer is offering incredible deals on America's best-selling ATV lineup, the Rugged Rancher, Dependable Foreman, and Trail Hungry Rubicon. Right now, get up to $500 in bonus bucks on select models and fixed financing rates as low as 2.99%. So if you're ready to ride red and save serious green, then head to the Honda ATV clearance event today.
Where you get your weather matters.
This is a large and dangerous tornado.
That's why we get real local the moment you need it.
We are live in Oklahoma, Arkansas, Mississippi, Florida.
Real accurate.
This is round one of the severe storms that are coming through.
From real experts on the ground.
That is a gust front for you right there in Dusty, Texas. Wow.
Where you get your weather matters.
This is basically what makes the Weather Channel.
Keep the Weather Channel on.
Here at the Weather Channel.
The Weather Channel is out in full force today.
Only the Weather Channel.
So I've officially named your site, Sam, Taj Masam.
Taj Masam. I love it.
That was Thursday night. That was also Dr. Greg Postel on keyboards.
Yeah.
He actually provided
the
music.
In case you didn't know, Keyboard Cat and Dr. Greg Postel, a duet.
One
beautiful.
And the same. One and the
beautiful
same.
Beautiful moment.
Hey, that was, of course, same champion, and it was also, help me with this, it was Jim Cantore.
And
it was Creek Stewart. Absolutely, and that's a small taste of what it really truly means to survive in the wilderness, and it's all ahead on season two for the premiere of Fat Guys in the Woods.
Creek season two, congratulations. We're rolling into season two.
Thank you.
Let's look back before we look forward. Let's talk a little bit about season one. You're out there in the wilderness. There had to be a few rough weather moments. What was one of the worst you can think of?
Man, I have always said weather is and always has been man's number one survival adversary, yeah. And it is definitely true in this show.
Yeah.
Because I can remember one instance in Kentucky where we started the week with literally 18 inches of snow on the ground. Imagine that, building a brush hut with 18 inches of snow. As the week progressed, it warmed up. Snow melted, turned to slush, then it started raining, but it was still only in the low 40s. Slushy, it was absolutely a worst case nightmare scenario in a survival situation.
All right, so food.
Worst thing you can think of that you've ever had to use as fuel? Well, I tell you, one of them is on the first episode of season two, and that is tarantula. It was absolutely disgusting. Even once you got past the mental idea of eating a tarantula, you know, and this is one meal that these three guys will never forget.
All right. We'll take a bite out of this. Season two of Fat Guys in the Woods kicks off tomorrow night at 9.
Okay, we're going to talk about the severe weather in the forecast when we come back.
The most legendary name in paint is now at Lowe's.
What is his name?
Oh, it's HGTV Home by Sherwin-Williams.
Is he more famous than me?
It's the name everyone wants on their wall.
Well, now there's room for all of us.
Sure.
Back to the happy tree?
But nothing looks better on ceilings either.
Come again?
So, if you're looking for the most legendary name in paint...
What?
I said if you're...
I can't hear you.
Never mind. HGTV Home by Sherwin-Williams is now at Lowe's.
If you've been wishing for something amazing, at Cricket Wireless, we've got it. A special offer on the new Samsung Galaxy S6. Plus, we've got more 4G LTE coverage nationwide than T-Mobile or Sprint. Because a great phone deserves a great network. Cricket Wireless, something to smile about.
One of the Foots' favorite rituals happens at the water's edge. Here, they must look their best. Smooth, beautiful skin is an advantage. The others can only hide in shame. Introducing the new Dr. Scholl's Dreamwalk Express Petty.
Deep in the dark, untouched recesses of your engine is power you never knew it could produce. And Vapor can set it free. New Stable 360 Performance unleashes that exclusive Vapor technology that rises above the fuel line to protect your engine where other additives can't. To help keep your engine running cleaner, leaner, smoother, and stronger than ever. The next level of performance is in the Vapor. Stable 360 Performance.
Currently in our area, 75 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 86. Chance of rain 60%. Tonight, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Low 74. Sunday, partly cloudy. High 85. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
More than 50 million people are under the threat for severe weather this weekend, from the plains to the Ohio Valley. I'll tell you who needs to be on alert for large hail, damaging winds, and even tornadoes.
And Hurricane Blanca spinning its way toward shore. Yeah, making a close call there right now. It has 120 mile an hour winds, and it's setting its sights pretty close to the Baja Peninsula. We're going to time out that risk.
And a warning this morning, after all that record rainfall across the southern plains in a super wet week, is expected up and down the East Coast. Find out what hidden hazards could be lurking after rounds and rounds of heavy rain.
Omaha, Nebraska. This is a look at the Creighton University campus. Some trees there, obviously not seeing much sky, but later on today, those overcast skies could turn stormy. A torcon of 4 in place for Omaha and a lot of other places as well. Dr. Postel is going to break that down for us in just a couple minutes, but first, good morning. Welcome to AMHQ Weekend. It's Saturday, June the 6th. I'm Kate Parker, and I got to tell you, I missed the Three Stooges here.
Yeah.
It's been a while since we've all three been in studio.
That's right. It has been a while. I'm Reynolds Wolf, by the way. We've got Dr. Greg Postel, and we're all three here to talk about really the big picture. It looks like rough weather possible for parts of the country again.
Yeah, Central Plains, the northern parts of Nebraska, Dakotas. Watch out for big storms today. All modes in play, including even some tornadoes from Sioux Falls all the way down through Omaha.
And then we've got major hurricanes. Hurricane Blanca. This wasn't a major hurricane when you went to bed last night, but this morning it is, and it's getting awfully close to Cabo San Lucas. Will it impact that area? We're going to talk about that.
Yeah, certainly a hot topic, and so is this one in the Pacific Northwest, where temperatures are going to be on the upswing, anywhere from 10 to 30 degrees higher than normal, 100s possible in the valley. I will tell you that some places, like Northern California, could get up to 102.
Oof.
I know. There you
hot
go, guys.
Stuff. Okay, speaking of hot stuff, take a look at this tornado near Vona, Colorado, and this was on Friday afternoon. So far, no reports of damage or injuries because it was a sparsely populated area there on the east coast, the eastern plains of Colorado there. We've got even more severe weather in the forecast, though, today. You guys, Colorado, this time of year, a dangerous spot to be.
My gosh, you're absolutely right about that. You know what, Kate? We've got another weekend that's packed with severe weather. And Dr. Greg Postel is with us. You know, last couple of weekends, we've seen this kind of interesting setup. It's been repeating itself. Will this situation today be a repeat of what we saw in Colorado yesterday?
It might. I mean, it really might, because the ingredients are there for all modes of severe weather, hail, high winds, and tornadoes, although I think hail and high winds probably more so than tornadoes, but still with torcons of 4, 40% chance of a tornado within 50 miles of a location up in here in eastern Nebraska, western Iowa, and even southern South Dakota. So watch out in Sioux Falls, Omaha, and all the lovely towns in between for the redevelopment of thunderstorms today. Right now, we got some there moving across I-80 and getting close to Kansas City there in northeastern Kansas and northwestern Missouri. These are weakening, but moving southeastward, they're diving that direction and will continue to move that way along a stationary boundary that will actually serve as a focus for more storms later on today as well. So here's some thunderstorms moving through the Kansas City area, St. Joe, Leavenworth County, maybe Lawrence, Olathe. You'll get some storms too in the next hour, and that might delay some of your plans if you were counting on outdoor ones early in the day. But I think later on today, things will clear out again, and then we'll see new storms forming. This is a boundary to watch. This is where it's happening now, and we'll be tracking those storms riding southeastward during the next several hours along that boundary. But later on today, it's going to shift northward sort of as a warm front, bring some of that more humid and warmer air northward, greater instability toward this region of faster winds. Notice that's where the fast winds aloft are near the jet stream. That's where those storms will be sort of supported by those high altitude winds, the wind shear. That will keep those storms big and strong up that way and will lead to severe weather, we think, across parts of Nebraska, South Dakota, and parts of western Minnesota. All these guys right in here may be supercellular with all modes in play, including a tornado or two, and then shifting into probably parts of the western Great Lakes overnight tonight, maybe turning into a damaging wind threat. Kate, back to you.
Okay, so it's not just tonight, though, that we're talking about, Dr. Postel. We've got a threat tomorrow and into Monday. Currently in Detroit, though, enjoy it. Look how beautiful it is. Sunny today, high near 70. It's in the 50s right now. Nice, cool morning jog going to be a possibility for you. But things are going to change. Let's take a look at how things progress as we go throughout the next couple of days. Currently, Detroit, like I said, you're sunny, but we do have a little bit of cloud cover from Indianapolis to Columbus into Pittsburgh. We've got that going on. And look at the rain in New York City. Man, you saw about 0.2 inches this morning at Central Park. We've got Long Island starting to dry out a little bit, but you do have a couple more showers back behind that. And this is the spot that we're really watching, right? Elmont today for the Belmont. That's right. Post time is at 6:50 p.m. Will it be dry? It looks like yes. This morning, that track getting a little bit wet, maybe compacting the dirt a little bit. We'll see how that affects the race. But later on this afternoon, temperature's going to be in the lower 70s, maybe upper 60s at race time. You're going to see a little peak of sunshine, we think, before the sun sets. And that is what it'll look like for those horses as they run in the Belmont Stakes. And we'll see if American Pharoah makes it. What do you think, Reynolds?
I don't know. It's going to be interesting. I certainly
hope so. Powerful animal.
Yeah, a phenomenal animal. But right now, in terms of the deep south, in terms of the horsepower we can see from these storms, hey, folks, it may be kind of tough sledding for a lot of you out there. Could see quite a bit of rain coming down in places. What we had up in northeast, where they're going to be having the nice race in terms of the showers, you may see showers racing the way through parts of Florida, through the Carolinas. Washington, D.C., you can't rule out a chance of raindrops there, too. You got the frontal boundary that's going to drift its way to the southeast. Some moisture, of course, the surface. High dew points are going to help give you chances of some storms. storms. Many of them look like they might be maybe along the coast, perhaps a few in the Piedmont, but for the most part, it does look like coastal activity. It's going to be the colliding sea breeze in Florida that's going to help generate some storms right along parts of the I-10, I-75, I-95 corridor. As we get to the afternoon, that's the really going to start sparking up. Might see some extreme South Florida alligator alley. You might have some toad stranglers in terms of some heavy rain there. You just got to be ready for that. All right, Kate, let's send it right back over to you.
You know, somewhere else that you got to be ready for a lot of moisture going to be the Baja Peninsula. Look at this. This is Hurricane Blanca, now a Category 3 storm, 120-mile-an-hour winds. You can see that waves certainly going to be an issue. Rip currents going to be an issue along the entire east coast of Mexico. But look at the Baja Peninsula. It makes you kind of nervous looking at this and saying, okay, this is inching pretty close to Cabo San Lucas. It's honeymoon season. We've got a lot of people there. We're going to talk about your full forecast with this with Dr. Postel coming up in just a couple minutes. Reynolds.
Okay, thanks so much. Well, when AMHQ weekend rolls on, we've got the recent flooding rains that have affected so many people, many folks worried about mold in their homes. We're going to let you know what you can do to prevent it and the signs that might, well, tell you that you've got a mold problem. We've got the expert coming up who's going to give us a heads up on that. Hey, get heads up on this. This is a great shot was sent in to us. Lightning show near Oakley, Kansas. If you'd like to share some with us, you can do it. We'll spread it around with everyone. AMHQ weekend returns.
Let's do this. Let's move outdoors for the next few months. Let's build a kitchen under the clouds. A dining room with no walls, no ceiling. Let's put it all together. Then, let's get together. A lot. Let's do this. Plant color everywhere with 12-pack annuals, just $9.98. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
I've got plans. And this is my baby right now. So it's just not the right time to get pregnant. That's why I chose Skyla. Skyla is the small, flexible IUD that prevents pregnancy for up to 3 years. So for me, there are no daily pills or monthly refills. I got my Skyla placed in just a few minutes at my OBGYN's office. And if I want to try to get pregnant, I can get it removed whenever I want.
If you have a pelvic infection, get infections easily, or have certain cancers, don't use Skyla. Less than 1% of users get a serious infection called PID. If you have persistent pelvic or stomach pain, or if Skyla comes out, tell your doctor. Skyla may attach or grow through the uterus and cause other problems. Pregnancy while using Skyla is uncommon, but can be life-threatening and may result in loss of pregnancy or fertility. Ovarian cysts may occur, but usually disappear. Bleeding and spotting may increase in the first 3 to 6 months and remain irregular. Periods over time usually become shorter, lighter, or may stop. Skyla does not protect against HIV or STDs.
Talk to your OBGYN about making the move to Skyla.
Check with your insurance to find out if you can get Skyla at no cost.
The Weather Channel's most watched original program.
And it just hit us.
Is back.
This is just the beginning of what's to come.
Currently in our area, 75 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon, high 85. Chance of rain, 60%. Tonight, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Considerable cloudiness, low 74. Sunday, partly cloudy, high 85. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
With us right here on AMHQ, the whole team.
Right, either go all in or just tap out.
Here we go. I told you, we're going to bust out of this drought.
As we say, keep watching with us this morning because we're all watching history happen together.
Check out that snow. Wait, that's not snow. Oh, that's hail. Hail coming down hard in Lyons, Colorado. This is from Thursday. Hail measured about an inch to rims, damaging cars, and it caused all kinds of roof damage on homes. Colorado could deal with more severe weather as we make it through the weekend. In fact, we've got three cities for you on the Saturday where the Torcon could be at least a 3 or 4. These places, it's going to be a 4 in Omaha, Nebraska, Lincoln, Nebraska, and Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Also, the time frame between 6 p.m. and 2 a.m. for Omaha, Nebraska. Also, possibly afternoon, evening, and then overnight for Lincoln, Nebraska, all day for Sioux Falls. Here's a look at Sioux Falls. Your forecast shows that we're going to be going from the clouds to the sunny clouds, and then thunder boomers can be anticipated through the evening hours, with those hit or miss storms becoming far more prevalent by 7 p.m. and into 9 p.m. as well. All right, that's the latest. What you can expect in places like Sioux Falls. Let's hit it back over to Kate. She's got more.
Yeah, you know what, Reynolds, it's going to be a really long time before places like Texas, Oklahoma recover from the recent rain, the flooding. So it's important that people be mindful of one thing with their homes: mold. The situation doesn't have to be extreme like what we've seen in the Southern Plains. You can actually see mold in situations where you don't have flooding like this. But it's one of those words that really sends shudders of, you know, nervousness down your spine. Yep. So joining us now is J.D. Ortega. You're with No Mold Atlanta,
yep,
the owner of that. And it, like we were saying, it doesn't have to be flooding, right, that causes
mold issues? Yeah, because, you know, really and truly, mold is already in our houses, and all it's waiting for is water and a food source. So when you have this onslaught of water that gets into our houses, mm-hmm, it's just within no time the mold is going to start growing. So it's really, really critical that you attack it the right way and that you know how to recognize it.
And okay, so first let's try and identify mold. What are some of the signs that you would look for in your home?
Okay, well, what you're looking for is mold grows kind of like it has tentacles, and I mean, once it grows, it's pretty obvious. A lot of times it can be black. Mm-hmm. You know, when these kind of water issues that these people are having, it's usually going to be a black mold situation, which is a very toxic situation. Okay.
Yeah, I was wondering, you know, because you hear mold and it's kind of like one of those no-go subjects, especially if you're house hunting or if you're just, you know, in your house, you see here mold and it's because it's toxic?
Yeah, because what happens is that when the mold is growing, when it gets water, it's growing. When it's growing, it's fruiting. And fruiting means that it starts releasing mycotoxins.